So anything that has two states corresponds to one bit. Heads or tails, as well as true or false, 0 or 1. If you have four states, well, that corresponds to two bits. But now, what corresponds to three bits? Now, would it be six states? No, actually what happens is that you have eight states. That corresponds to three bits. So why is this so? So if I look at three bits, I can have 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1, 1. 3 bits. Eight states. All I'm doing is just counting out, and here you see me counting in binary notation. These are just the numbers 0, 1. 0, 1, 0 is 2 in binary notation. 0, 1, 1 is 3. 1, 0, 0 is 4. 1, 0, 1 is 5. 1, 1, 0 is 6. 1, 1, 1 is 7. Which shows rationale behind the old joke, which is that there are 10 different kinds of people in the universe, those who understand binary notation and those who don't. So, if I go to more bits, so if I have n bits, where n is equal to 1, 2, 3, etc., what it means is that I have 2 to the n different possibilities. Or sometimes called states. So I can have 0, 0, dot, 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 0, 0, 0, dot, 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 1, 0, 0, dot, 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 1, 0, 0, 0, dot, 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 1, 1. You can tell there's a heck of a lot of possibilities here, and end up going 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, dot, 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 1. So this is 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, and this is 2 to the n minus 1, because 2 to the n would be 1, 0, 0, 0, dot, 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 0, which is 2 to the n. So when you're counting in binary, when you have bits, you have, for a relatively small number of bits, you can have a very, very, very large number of possible states or possible things that you could label with these bits. In fact, it's an interesting question to ask, how many bits are there in the universe? How many bits in the universe? Well, this seems kind of a crazy question. You would think, well, you know, there's an infinite number of bits in the universe. But actually, this is not so. If you look at an R universe, which is the part that we have access to since the Big Bang, which was, last time I read, it was 13 times 10 to the ninth years ago. and so the part of the universe that could be within 13 billion light years in any direction, this amount is actually finite. This is a rather surprising result that the amount of information in the universe is finite. It comes from the laws of quantum mechanics, but it turns out that within the universe there are 10 to the 90 particles. Most of these are microwave photons from the black body radiation that's left over from the Big Bang. They're all over the place. They're around us right now. They're particles of light whose wavelength is roughly about that size. There are 10 to the 90 of them, so this is A1 followed by 90 zeros in ordinary digital notation. And each of these particles carries a few bits of information with it. And in fact, if you go to the absolute limits that are allowed by the laws of physics, The total number of bits that could be allowed would be 10 to the 120, which is a 1 followed by 120 zeros. These are large numbers of bits, but they're not infinite. They're big numbers, but I could think of much bigger numbers. For instance, 10 to the 120 plus 1 is bigger than 10 to the 120, or 10 to the 220, or 10 to the 240. They're large numbers, but there's a large number of, there's a finite number of bits, and a large number of bits, but it's finite. Now, what does this mean?